Now, the Federal Reserve would like to make everybody believe we're back on steady financial footing here in America. The various candidates for president on all sides would like us to be safe, that when they say they're elected, they know what they're doing. They'll have a firm grasp on what will keep us monetarily sound and secure. Belief is a beautiful thing until you deal in harsh realities and face the future. He's a veteran of Wall Street, national and global economies, author of The American Dream Under Fire, Steve Beamon. Joined by the Wall Street Journal best-selling author and managing director of ARK Financial Management, Robert Wiedemer. Gentlemen, thanks so much for joining us. Steve, I'm going to begin with you. All of the presidential candidates that are sitting out there right now saying, we are the ones that can get the job done. Do you get the sense that any of them have a real solid idea of what it takes in order to run a national economy?
Well, I think, as you and I've talked before, Ed, there is a disconnect between someone who knows about the economy and someone who performs in the economy. So I'd have to give the knowledge base to the Carly Fiorinas. I think she spent time running big business. She understands management of labor. She understands capital costs. She understands supply and demand issues. So I would give her the lead. Trump, I would say he's got a great real estate background, and he's certainly the master of leverage. So if we want him to get us out of debt, he's probably the right guy to do it. But as you go down, you've got mixed bags among the rest.
So, Robert, then to you, when it comes down to this, it would seem that if you put the people who've been in business before and then take the guys and the gals who've been governors before, that they would have a real leg up. But do they?
You know, you would think so, but it's not all about knowledge, is it? It's also about willingness to maybe take a tough stand, willingness to get into conflict with people, to do the right thing, to be a leader. So I think we have to add that more than just knowledge, because, you know, most of the candidates are, you know, fairly well-educated, bright people, but are they really willing to do the tough choices or make the tough choices that are going to be important, Ed?
Aren't one of those choices or some of those choices, Robert, choosing the people that you will help, that will help you run a government? Because let's face it, the president sits there, he or she, whatever, and they've got a million people around them. If you pick the wrong people to help you run an economy, you're doomed.
Oh, no question about that. And, you know, I'll tell you, though, you know, one of the people that's most important to pick, they're not going to pick for a while, right? One is Janet Yellen. She's in for almost another 5 years. So that's one key person that really nobody's going to get to pick, and I don't think anybody's going to kick her out. So she's in no matter what, and she's in the power position. Treasury Secretary, things like that, that's important. We've had good people like John Paulson, but Hank Paulson. But, you know, Hank Paulson, you know, presided over the financial crisis. He's very capable, very financially astute, and a good advisor. But, you know, it was the financial crisis he had to deal with. And, well, it wasn't necessarily of his own doing, but just being schooled in Wall Street doesn't necessarily mean you're all that good at handling it.
So, Steve, when we talk about presidents and what they're able to do and the people that they have involved with them, I think Robert brings up a good point here, some of the people that you are stuck with from the very beginning. So when we look for that person to run the economy and get it up and get it running and make it work, are we sometimes asking just too much? Because one person, even if you pick the right people, you're still stuck with certain things when you get into that White House.
And I wouldn't think that's the case. I think one person can readily do this job, but they've got to be an extraordinary manager, they have to be a leader, and they have to believe in principles that the American people will believe in. I think if you look at Dwight Eisenhower, if you look at Ronald Reagan or Bill Clinton, all three of those people brought to that office that managerial skill, as well as that visionary leadership that the segments of the population they needed bought into it.
All right, let's go ahead and talk about a couple of things international here, 45, 90 seconds or so that we have left here. Steve, to you first with China. The China shares capped the week. They had a two-day rally. Everything looks rosy, so we're told at least. But they're encouraging brokerages to buy stocks to make it easier to invest with borrowed funds. Something doesn't quite sound right in that.
Well, I get a little nervous whenever I hear people borrowing money when their debt is 200% of their GDP, and that's where China's situation is. I think to continue the growth in China, you're going to have to see them pare back that debt. I think they'll have to get the municipalities to start surviving on their own and not just throwing money at it. And we saw them recently put this restriction on selling stock to majority shareholders, and that's going to hurt the Chinese capital markets. So they've got a long way to go to get that economy back in shape.
Hey, Robert, let's talk about throwing money here. The EU has approved $7.6 billion in basically a bridge financing loan to Greece. I've read and studied this as much as I can. I'm not an economist. I just play one on TV, but it sure looks like we're throwing bad money after bad just over and over again here in Greece.
Well, the IMF, the International Monetary Fund, basically said earlier this week that Greece has no chance of paying any of this off, 30 years or more. So You're not in small company when the IMF agrees with you that there's really no chance that Greece will pay any of this back. It's expected their GDP is going to decline 4% next year, probably even worse.
20 seconds to you then, Steve. They're not going to pay anything back. You agree with that and another collapse here?
I think I agree with it. Whether it's a collapse or not, I don't know. I think the banks are going to have to take a haircut, and I see you could see a mass exodus of young talent out of Greece, which is a tragedy.
I think that's the bigger issue more than anything else. We keep talking about the monetary issue, but there's a lot of young Greeks right now who are just deciding, this is not the country for me. Wait till that happens and they lose their workforce. That is going to be something else to face. Reminder once again, Robert Wiedemer recently recorded a video explaining exactly why we might see a market collapse. Simply go to aftershockinfo.com. And also, Steve Beaman joins us quite frequently here on the Hardline to talk about what's happening in the economy as well. Gentlemen, thanks so much for joining us. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, Ed.
All right, stay with us. We'll continue right here on the fastest 60 minutes in news, The Hardline.